La salle, je vois que la réaction est positive. Je n'entends pas d'objection. L'accord de Paris pour le climat est accepté.
December the 12th, 2015 was a pivotal moment. There was a sense of progress, of hope and ambition. The US President Barack Obama said at the time, the Paris Agreement establishes
the enduring framework the world needs to solve the climate crisis.
At its core, the Paris Agreement establishes a pathway to mitigating and adapting to climate change in a fair way. To limit global warming to well below 2 degrees Celsius, ideally to 1.5 degrees, the idea was that all countries will cut emissions, but developed countries would move further, faster, and provide finance and technology to developing countries. At the time, it was recognized that ambition was not sufficient to achieve 2C, let alone 1.5C, but that ambition would be raised gradually over time. But is this framework working? To answer this, we need to look at the national emissions targets in the nationally determined contributions, or NDCs as they're called. To do that, we can use the model that we developed with the World Bank called the Climate Policy Assessment Tool, or CPAT. This allows for the quantification of emissions targets and of climate ambition. So here's the good news. Our key finding is that the Paris Agreement is making progress. Since 2015, the NDCs have become more stringent. However, we need to see significantly more mitigation ambition and action in this decade. Specifically, we need to cut greenhouse gas emissions by 25 to 50% below 2019 levels by 2030. But globally, current targets only achieve about an 11% cut in emissions. So how do we close this gap in an equitable way? Our proposal is to have all countries reduce emissions versus business as usual, depending on how wealthy they are. Most countries would then raise their ambition, but high-income countries would cut emissions by more than middle or low-income countries. We can compare country targets to what's needed for different temperature goals. As you can see, there is a lot of variation between countries, but some patterns can be identified. Firstly, very few countries are in the range of about 2C, and no country is currently ambitious enough to achieve 1.5C. High-income countries are generally more ambitious than, say, upper middle-income countries, and as a collective have become much more ambitious since 2015. Secondly, upper middle-income countries have raised their climate ambition somewhat, but overall are further from what's needed for 2C and 1.5C than high-income, lower middle, and low-income countries. Scaling up climate ambition globally is therefore crucial. But ambition is not nearly enough. Another recommendation we make is to accelerate implementation through complementary agreements between countries. This could include an agreement on minimum carbon prices or other measures with equivalent outcomes. We also need to drastically increase mitigation investment. Global investment in energy needs to increase sixfold by 2030. On flows of finance, developed countries aim to mobilize $100 billion in climate finance to developing countries by 2020. But unfortunately are likely to meet this target late. Lastly, we need much faster development and diffusion of low carbon technologies such as electric vehicles, heat pumps, green steel, and others. So overall, progress has been made since the 2015 signing of the Paris Agreement. But to mitigate climate change, we need much more ambition and action in this decade. But identifying and quantifying gaps is one thing. Finding the political will to close them is another altogether.